New Orleans, the Big Easy, the Lakers, LeBron coming in what looks like my pajama pants versus the Pelicans. A lot at stake, LeBron James. Hey, it's not just the scoring, it's the assist. The lob to Anthony Davis, Lakers go up by 9. The assists were all over the place for LeBron, throws it over to Davis again. 8 assists in the first quarter for LeBron, tied for the most by any player in the first quarter this season. Los Angeles would start to pull away. LeBron find Rui Hachimura for the dunk. LeBron now up to 12 assists. It's not done to Hachimura again. 13 assists in the first half, the most in any half in his career, by the way. The Lakers leading 70-53 at the half, early in the third quarter. Davis with the steal. Lakers, we're going the other way. LeBron, no luck. Davis slams it home. LeBron finished 17 assists in the game. But I want to score, too. I'm just going to post up from 3. Clean up on aisle 3, though. Gets his own rebound, lays it in. Lakers win. LeBron on what he learned tonight against the Pelicans.
What are you feeling like or hoping the team can step up knowing that you have New Orleans again on Tuesday?
Each game is different. It's going to have its own challenges. So, you know, we could take a few things from tonight, but at the end of the day, the game is going to be won in between the four lines on Tuesday. So we got to come out with, you know, the same intensity. We got to lock in defensively. We got to not turn the ball over, and we got to get shots. And if we do that, we'll be all right.
So no travel plans needed for the Lakers as they face the Pelicans again in New Orleans on Tuesday. After the game, the Lakers' travel plan is written plain and clear on the locker room whiteboard. Back to the hotel, rinse and repeat. The Lakers win in NOLA, and they lock the 7th seed to go on and face the Nuggets in the first round. Warriors head to Sacramento, taking on the Kings. Winner of that game will face the loser of the Lakers Pelicans for the 8th.
They're number 8. They'll play the Pelicans, who are the 7th seed, and the game will be played Tuesday. You watch your whoever wins this game will be the number 7th seed, and they'll face the Nuggets. Whoever loses plays the winner of the 9-10, and that matchup will be the 8th seed, and they'll play the OKC Thunder.
You know what's funny? Listen, even if I don't know the game of basketball, I understand this is a very important series for the Lakers, right? But I don't even think it's going to be about LeBron. I don't even think it's going to be about AD. I think it's going to be about the supporting cast. So for you, I'm going to ask you, who do you think would be a bigger factor in the Lakers game? Would it be Austin Reeves or would it be D'Angelo Russell?
Man, look here.
Or a combination of both? Because they got, I think those two got to play well, or one of the two got to play extremely well and be able to keep up with the production of LeBron and AD.
The Lakers, when AD and LeBron, I'm counting on AD and LeBron to be AD and LeBron. We saw those guys the other night against Memphis, and they had to go, had to play damn near 40 minutes against the Grizzlies G League team. But I like that kid, G Jackson. He had another monster game today. But when Austin Reeves and D'Lo, especially D'Lo shooting those threes, because he can play the pick and roll, he's tremendous. And then, you know, you want to help on AD, and then he gets to let those three balls go. So this is twice that they played the Pelicans in the in-season tournament and blew them out. They played them again today and blew them out. Now they're going to have to go back to they're not going back. They're going to stay there. Got to play them. I just like the matchup. I think the Lakers match up very, very well against them. They'll have no answer for LeBron. They have no answer for AD. The question is that B.I. was on a minutes restriction. The question is, he just got back. How much they might throw caution to the wind and say, B.I., go until you can't go. But then maybe it's like, nah, we need you for the long haul. Zion did not have a good game today. I think he's going to come out, try to be more aggressive. LeBron did a great job on him. Hey, I'm going to concede anything 15 feet out, you shoot it. But you have I ain't gonna let you get to this basket.
So that mean basically, obviously, is the clock ticking on Zion Williamson also to take that next step and play at a high level, especially in the playoffs?
Well, but listen, here's the thing, Ocho. He played. Look, there is no question when he's on the court, he's a wrecking ball, athletic, quick, give you 20, can you know, average 25, probably 25, 6 and 7. Yeah, you probably like to see those rebounds go up. but he, I think he had what, like he had like 8 or 9 assists today. So he's a pretty good job. I've seen him at times run the offense through him. His biggest thing is staying on the court. His biggest thing.
Health wise, you mean? Health wise?
He's got to control his weight. If he can control his weight, he's a phenomenal talent. He's a more athletic Charles Barkley. That's what he is.
Okay.
Now, people don't realize, I mean, you know, they see Charles and they think that's all he was. Charles led the league in rebounding at 6'4". That's Charles Barkley. So he could be that. He should be that if he keep his weight under control. But I like the way he's played this year. He's a phenomenal talent. Everybody knows he's a phenomenal talent. But I got the Lakers. I think, and now all things being equal, would I be disappointed the Lakers lost and then won the 8-9 matchup? Nope, because that means they get the Thunder, and I think they match up better against the Thunder than they do the Nuggets. Thunder. But
wait, Shy don't scare you? No.
Mm-mm. Nikola Jokic scared me. Jamal Murray. They're as good as anybody in clutch situations.
Yeah.
Last 5 minutes game within 5 points. Nikola Jokic is a monster. Jamal Murray knows when game time and he can take the game over. Michael Porter Jr. can make timely big shot after big shot after big shot. Mm-hmm. And they've been there and done that. OKC has yet to get there and do that. So I'm always going to take a team that's been there and done that. And you're talking about the MVP, Nikola Jokic. So yeah, they put fear in everybody. But if I'm the Lakers have played well the last couple of games. So the Lakers and the Warriors get into play in the T-Wolves 3-6 matchup. They get the Suns. They lost the Suns. They could have been the second. If they'd have won, they'd have been the 2 seed, right? If they'd have won today. Yeah. They'd have been the 2 seed, but that's what they are. That's where they are right now in the Eastern. Yeah. All the Nuggets had to do was beat the Spurs, but Wimby goes crazy on Friday night. The number one seed is the Boston Celtics. They're 64-18. The Knicks in overtime secure the number 2 seed. The Bucks are the 3 seed. Cleveland are the 4 seed. Orlando, the 5 seed. Pacers, 6. And so the play-in is Sixers, Miami for the right to play the Knicks, and then the Chicago and Atlanta for the right to play Boston.
I'm finna watch. Now I'm finna lock in. I'm gonna take me notes when they playing, so I'm gonna be able to talk about it. Shoot.
The Knicks. I like the Knicks, but
hey,
if he can stay healthy in this series,
yeah,
that's a big if because he missed 2 months with that knee. With Joel Embiid, Tyrese Maxey, Kelly Oubre Jr., and what's the other guy's name? Tobias Harris.
Yeah.
I like them against the Knicks. I do. I believe the Sixers are going to beat Miami. I do. I know the Heat.
Whoa. Simmer down a little bit. Bam, Jimmy Butler, Tyler Hero. We got Baby Jesus. I call him Baby Jesus, the young rookie from UCLA.
Jaime Hawkins.
Yeah. I call him Baby Jesus. You don't just come in and think they just finna come high down here in Miami.
No, well, y'all play them in Philly.
Well, we gonna beat them in Philly too. What you talking about? It's the Heat.
Okay.
It's Jimmy Butler. Playoff time. Look at Jimmy Butler's stats in the regular season and what he does in his playoff time.
He's phenomenal in the postseason.
Yeah. So what make you think we finna go into Philly and may have a Philly cheesesteak, man? Stop playing. And that's no disrespect to my Philly people because I know y'all.
No,
you know I
love
you.
Too late. It's disrespect. It's disrespect.
Because the people in Philly love me. They good. They know I mean no
and
harm.
Atlanta and Chicago for the right to play the Boston Celtics. I think that'll be quick work in that situation. Whoever. Mm-hmm. But I mean, the last week, I haven't liked what I've seen from the Celtics.
What's wrong with them? They inconsistent.
Here's the thing, Ocho. This team takes and they makes a lot of threes. So a lot of what there is contingent on is taking and making threes. And you know you can get hot and make a bunch and shoot, but
And when you cold, you cold.
But here's the thing. Sometimes they race out the big leads. They keep shooting threes, and they let the other and they shoot themselves right into a situation where the team is right back in the ball game.
Right, right.
So, I mean, but there, I mean, you look at Tatum and you look at Porzingis, you look at JB, Derek White. I mean, they got guys, Pritchard coming off the bench. Al Horford. They got a solid squad. But sometimes you just look at them like, bro, how y'all blew a 23-point lead? How y'all blew a 26-point lead?
Mm-hmm. Damn. Hey, you know, the game of basketball is a game of runs.
Yes.
You know, it's a game of runs. It's